So I just did a video on Mocha parameter tracking inside a Continuum FCP. We saw point-based tracking in chroma bands as well as our lens flares. But parameter tracking can also refer to corner pinning. If you have the stylized unit pack, you'll be able to try this out in BCC plus light. But it goes beyond corner pinning just BCC effects. In fact, with Continuum FCP and our transform effect, you can corner pin anything you want from the Final Cut Pro timeline. Let's take a look at that in this video. Okay, so I have a Final Cut Pro timeline here. And what I'd like to do is change out what we're seeing in the phone to be the clip that I have above that I've just turned off. So I want to place that or corner pin it to the phone. Few steps need to be taken in order to get this right. So let's do them carefully one by one. First of all, I want to take my base clip, which I will be tracking, and I want to place it into a compound clip based on the order of operations in Final Cut. I'm going to call this Mocha Track CP for corner pin. Press OK. And now in the BCC perspective category, find BCC transform. Now you might be tempted to play with the on-screen controls here, but for best bets, I suggest hopping inside of Mocha. We can do that really easily by going to the Mocha parameter track. So as you can see, I'm in the Essentials workspace, and we actually have two different boxes to work with. One is actually going to represent our corner pin data in Final Cut. So this is what we want to insert. And I'm going to just drag each of these points and get them flush with the actual plane of the phone. So by default, the surface blue box fits the entire screen. And in order to see this, you're going to want to zoom out. To get accurate, we can just press the Z key temporarily to zoom in on the image and make sure that we have these corner pins set up just right. In order to zoom out in this case, I'll just press Shift 8. Also press the Z key a bit so I can see the corner pin search area. And this represents where we'll be searching for the corner pin. Now there's something magical about this, and that is that we could have a search area completely independent of the actual corner pin in the cases that our object goes off screen or something obscures it, allowing us to perform offset tracking. In this case, I'll set the corner pin search area to be quite wide on the floor texture. Also make sure that it's rigid. And once complete, turn on the grid to make sure that the perspective of the corner pin is set up just right. So the reason I set up my track this way is that the phone screen changes when the name lights up. So if I just tracked the screen, it wouldn't be any good. It would be thrown off. Taking in the floor, which is almost the same movement as the phone, is a great place to track. Just keep in mind that we're going to have to make some minor adjustments to the surface shape to get this just right. Now with this information, it's time to track. And we'll go over to the left-hand side in the Essential tab and make sure that we track perspective in this instance. And I'll start off by tracking forward. We can see in the Mocha timeline a little green chevron, which refers to where we first started our track. I'll go back to that original point since my forward track is done and begin to track this backwards. Now you might see that there's a little tiny drift on each of the individual corner pins. And in order to perfect this, we're gonna hop into a new workspace and adjust our track. First thing first, let me wrist press Shift 8 so we can see this full screen. And I'll press the space bar in order for us to do a playback. I can see a little bit of that drift on the point on the bottom here, the bottom left and the bottom right, and somewhat on the top. And this is because these pixels change over time. Okay. So first off, I'm just going to line myself up with where I originally set up these points. And I want to switch my workspace from Essentials to Classic. In the Classic workspace, we're going to head, instead of this Track tab, to Adjust Track. And it's here where we can pinpoint perfectly where our corner pin should be and keyframe this information separate from the actual shape data. Keep in mind, this technique, which is going to be available in Adjust Track, shouldn't be used immediately when you have a bad track. it's really designed to help for these type of drifting problems that we're seeing here. In many cases, if you have a shaky or wobbly track, it's usually best to tweak your tracking settings or choose a different area to track. So first thing first, I just want to make sure that the points are perfect at this point. It's looking pretty good. And what I'll do under transform type is, because we're corner pinning, set up perspective, and then click set points. You should notice four purple icons or on each of the corner pin points. And this is going to represent the points that we want to be pinned at all times. You'll notice if I move my playhead forward that there is that drift that occurs on the lower left as well as the lower right. And one way to fix this is to select a point and actually use your arrow keys on an extended keyboard, nudging them up, down, left, and right. Alternatively, in the nudge section of adjust track, simply click auto. On the top left-hand corner, you'll notice that there's a reference frame, and that was the original point that you set. And here's the current frame. Since I set auto, this basically dives into place in most instances. I'm going to select the bottom right corner in this case, paying attention to the reference frame, and here's the current frame, and let's press auto to see that nudge take place in real time. Now, in many cases, auto will work great for each of the individual points, but you'll want to pay attention to the current frame and reference frame to ensure accuracy. Another thing to note is that I'm actually applying these adjustments on the arcs of the animation. So I'm trying to find out where the drift is at its highest point, and at that point is where I'm adding the keyframes. So I'm just going to go to the beginning of the timeline here, select the point on the lower left, and you might notice that there is a big change between the reference frame and the current frame right now, because the reference frame had the call taking place, where on the current frame, the screen is black. So if I press auto, it actually gets a little bit confused in terms of its point. So instead, what we can do is move it or nudge it based on using that reference frame or our arrow keys. I'll take the time to do this to each of the current frame, comparing it to the reference frame in the top left-hand corner. And once that's all set up, I'll click auto. That's looking pretty good for the current frame on the bottom right. I'll give this a playback so we can see the corner pin and any remaining drift. And that looks good to me to bring back inside of Final Cut Pro. So I'm going to close out of Mocha and let's press save. And we're going to see something weird right now. Right now, it's trying to corner pin the clip that we tracked, which we don't want. So I'm going to turn off the BCC transform effect, press Command C to copy that transform effect, and now paste it onto another clip. First off, let me press V to turn on what I want to corner pin. And we need to set its dimensions correctly, which is, we want this to be the same size as our project dimensions. This will involve us taking the scale X and dragging it up until it fits the frame of our project. Once that's done, like we did with our base clip, let's place this into a new compound clip and call it Track Phone. I'll press OK. Now go to the Edit menu, choose to paste the attributes of the BCC plus transform effect. Once I paste that, I'll remember that I turned off transform. So to see the results, just click on this little button. Now, what I wanted to corner pin into that phone screenshot is perfectly tracked into the scene. Okay, let's add an effect onto this phone just to have a little bit of a flicker. In order to do that, I'll show you a new effect inside of Continuum FCP called Light Flicker under the Film Style category. I'll apply it to the corner pinned asset, and we'll see that there's a flicker that takes place in a phone. In order to try to mimic someone calling, I'm going to head over to the effects editor, where we can preview a bunch of presets that ship with Light Flicker. I'll select Bright Random Flashing. Notice that we get quite an aggressive flicker in this case. And one thing we can do under our parameter settings is just choose a much lower amount. So I'll set this to something like 2. We have now this really subtle flicker that is occurring during the scene. I'll press apply and play this back full screen, so you could see that flicker results on the phone. Now, last but not least, keep in mind that we can combine this with Mocha masking workflows to have complex masks inside of the Final Cut Pro timeline. Let me fast forward to a more finished version of this project. So here is an example of this project a little bit further along. And there's one thing on top of this, which is I basically masked the phone back in. How this was accomplished is I'll double click to go inside the nest. And on the bottom here, this is the original clip plate. And on the top, this is a version of the clip with film stock supplied and the blending mode changed with this Mocha masking data. Inside the inspector, I'm going to change the blend mode right now to normal. And this is what I got from Mocha. So I went inside of Mocha. I'll go here to Mocha Mask under Film Stocks to show this to you, and basically just performed a mask-based track, as we can see here from layer one. Inside of Final Cut, under Pixel Chooser Mocha, I turned on View Matte Mask and set this to a very low feather under the mask properties. Since this was set to View Matte Mask, I can use this black and white luminance information to cut out a hole from the source clip. And that was achieved by heading to the opacity settings and setting this to Stencil Luma. I took these two elements and placed them inside a compound clip, and then just simply put this on top of the tracked plate using corner pinning inside of Final Cut Pro. I have a video on this technique that you can check out by clicking on the link below. For more tips and tricks just like this, don't forget to like and subscribe to us here on YouTube, as well as check out borisfx.com for the latest and greatest in information.